Dear students, welcome back to the lecture series of differentiation of functions. And today we will discuss derivative of parametric function. And this is the second video of this chapter. And this is our lecture number 10. So let's get into the video. So concentrate to the class. So we start with the question number 12 in the previous class. We have done up to question number 11, and here the parametric function is given in slight different way. This time you see sin x is equal to 2t by 1 plus t square and cos y is equal to 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square. Actually, in general, the parametric functions are given in two different equations by giving x is equal to some function of t and y is equal to given some function of t. And here sin x is given as a function of t and cos y is given as a function of t, and we can convert this sin x is equal to 2t by 1 plus t square in this way. That means x is equal to sin inverse of this term, and that will be a function of t, because sin inverse is a valid function, it is inverse trigonometric function. So let me solve this question. So we have given that it is sin x is equal to twice t by 1 plus t square. So x will be equal to, this is sin inverse of 2t by 1 minus t square, 2t by 1 plus t square. And simply, this sin inverse 2t by 1 plus t square is nothing but 2 tan inverse t, because we have a formula in the inverse trigonometric function that sin inverse 2t by 1 plus t square is equal to 2 tan inverse t, or cos inverse 1 minus t square divided by 1 plus t square. That is also is equal to 2 tan inverse t, and tan inverse of 2t by 1 plus t square, 1 minus t square, and that is also is equal to 2 tan inverse t. So here this sin inverse of 2t by 1 minus t 1 plus t square, this is actually is equal to 2 times of tan inverse t, and so we can find dx dt, 2 is remaining same, and tan inverse t function derivative is 1 by 1 plus t square. And so we take the second one, cos y is equal to 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square, that is this one. So y will be equal to cos inverse of 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square. And that is again the formula, same formula, it is 2 tan inverse t. Sin inverse of 2t by 1 plus t square is 2 tan inverse t. And cos inverse of 1 minus t square divided by 1 plus t square is also 2 tan inverse t. And this is a formula, and that will be obtained in the sector inverse trigonometric function. So you see here, derivative of this y is equal to 2 tan inverse t is 2 dy dx is equal to dy dt is equal to 2, again remaining same, and tan inverse t function derivative is 1 by 1 plus t square. So both the results are same actually, dx dt, this is 2 into 1 by 1 plus t square, and dy dt is also 2 into 1 by 1 plus t square. So result will be obviously 1. So dy dx is equal to dy dt divided by dx dt, and that is equal to this term divided by this term, and that will be give us 1 only. And that is the solution for the question. So let me take the next question, number 13. This one, x is equal to log of t plus sin t, and y is equal to e to the power t plus cos t. And this is a very simple question, you can solve yourself, because here if you take dx dt, then log t differentiation is simply 1 by t plus sin t differentiation is cos t only, and dy dt will be equal to e to the power t differentiation is e to the power t, and cos t differentiation is minus sin t, and then you take the division, and finally you will get the answer in very easy way. So I am leaving this question for you. And the next question, number 14. This is our question. If x is equal to a sin twice t into 1 plus cos 2t, and y is equal to b cos 2t into 1 minus cos 2t, then you show that this dy dx at t equal to pi by 4 is equal to b by a. So this is our question. Actually, first of all, we have to find this from this equation. We have to find dy dx from this equation first, and that result will be in t, and finally you are to replace this t by pi by 4 to get this result b by a. So first we begin with the given expression for x and to find dx dt. And before that you see, you do not differentiate dx dt directly here, because if you take some simplification here, then the process of differentiation will be easier than that direct differentiation. You can also take the direct differentiation here by using the quotient rule. This is a sin 2t is the first function and 1 plus cos 2t, this is the second function. By taking in that way also, you can find dx dt. But I am not taking that way. First of all, I will simplify this given expression to get a simple expression, and then we should find dx dt. So first I am taking this x is equal to this is a into this is given, then a into this sin 2t is multiplied here, this is sin 2t plus sin 2t into cos 2t, because this is multiplied with 1 to get sin 2t, and sin 2t into cos 2t is this one. A is remaining same, sin 2t is remaining same, and here you see if we have a 2 here, 2 into sin 2t into cos 2t will get us sin 4t. So if you take 2 here, then you are to take 1 by 2 also there. Actually this one, you see this term is actually half into taking another new 2 into sin 2t into cos 2t, simple sin 2t into cos 2t, this one. But this sin 2t into cos 2t, this term 2 into sin 2t into cos 2t, this will be equal to actually sin of 4t. You know this one, sin 4t formula is sin 2t formula actually, and this half is remaining, and this line I'm writing directly here, this one, this is the term, this one. Okay, so I am erasing this. Just so a into, we have now sin 2t plus half of sin 4t. Now we'll take the differentiation. Simple function is now sin 2t differentiation, sin for sin it is cos, and 2t's differentiation is 2 only, and sin 4t is cos 4t, and 4t differentiation is 4. So I am writing that line. So dx dt is equal to, this a is remaining here same, sin 2t is 2 cos 2t, actually sin derivative is cos and 2t derivative is 2, and I am writing directly here, half is already here, and sin 4t derivative is 4 into cos 4t, right? Very simple, and that is equal to 2 is, this 2 and 4 is cancelled, so remaining here 2, and that 2 can be taken outside of the bracket, mean twice a, it will be cos 2t, and this will be only sin 4t. So this is our expression for dx dt. Now take the second, y is equal to this. So here also you take a simple simplification. This b is here, b is already there, b, then cos 2t is this, and 1 minus cos 2t is this one. So b is here, this one, and as in the earlier case, this sin 2t is multiplied here. This time this cos 2t is multiplying with the term 1 minus cos 2t. So to get cos 2t, 1 is cos 2t, and cos 2t into cos 2t is cos square plus t. And we have a formula for cos square plus t. Or need not to write that one, directly you can differentiate this, because cos square function is obviously simple differentiation is there. 2 will come out, then cos, derivative of again cos, and then derivative of 2. Simple, I am taking dy dt. So dy dt is equal to, b is remaining here, cos 2t function derivative is minus sin 2t, and for 2t it is 2 only. So it is minus 2 sin 2t, this minus is here, cos square derivative is 2 cos 2t, square is coming in front of cos, so 2 cos 2t, then cos function derivative is minus sin 2t, and 2t function derivative is 2 only. Now you see, this minus will come here to get it is positive, this minus will come here. You see here, this one of the two can be taken outside. 2 is there. Then it is sine 2t is negative, minus sine 2t is this one, minus sine 2t, and this 2 is taken away, and here 2 sine 2t into cos 2t will get us sine 4t. So this is sine 4t, but this term is positive term. You see here, this term is positive term. So that positive term is written before the negative term. So simple, this term is this one, and this total term converted to sine 4t, and one of the two will remain there, and this 2 is taken outside the bracket. So we have only 2b into cos 4t minus sine 2t. Simple. And now you take dy dx and divide it. Dy dt divided by dx dt. So dy dx is equal to dy dt divided by dx dt. And keep in mind that this line is necessary. You should write this line in the process of differentiation of a parametric function. Do not write directly the answer. You always write this line, and after that you use the division. Do not write dy dx is equal to directly this one. Always you write this line. I noticed in the previous class that some of the students are writing the derivative dy dx directly this line by skipping this line. So my recommendation, do not skip this line, dy dt by dx dt. Always write this. So dy dt is this value writing here, and dx dt is this value. This value is writing here. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. B by A is here. Now it is sin C minus sin D formula. That is twice of C plus D, mean 4T plus 2T is 6T by 2. That is sin 3T. And then sin of C minus D, that is 4T minus 2T is 2T by 2 is D only. And here cos C plus cos D formula. So 2 into cos of C plus D means 6T divided by 2 is equal to 3T. And cos of this is minus 2t by 2 is minus t, and cos minus t is obviously cos t. So I am writing directly cos t. Actually it is cos of minus t, but cos minus t you can write is equal to simply cos t. And you see B by A, this 2 is cancelled, cos 3t is cancelled, only sin t divided by cos t, and that is 10t only. This term is cancelled, this part is cancelled. So B by A 10t. Actually you can find the result B by A by direct replacement of t is equal to pi by 4 in this line also. But in some cases, this question can ask in this way also, find dy dx, or show that dy dx is equal to this, then find dy dx at x is equal to t equal to pi by 4. So the problem can also be asked in that way also. And that is why I am finalizing the differentiation. Final line to look at the aniba. Then you replace t is equal to pi by 4 here. So dy dx at t equal to pi by 4 is equal to b by a, and 10 pi by 4, t is replaced by pi by 4. So 10 pi by 4 is 1 only. So it is simply b by a, and that is the answer. This one is the answer. So I think you understood this question. So let me take the next question, number 5, and this is an important question. If x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, then find dy dx by using parametric equations. So in this question, you have to know the parametric equation of this given Cartesian equation. This is a Cartesian equation, and you already know, actually this is the equation of ellipse. You already know in your first year class that the equation of ellipse is x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. So this is the equation of ellipse, and in the first year also we already know the parametric equation of ellipse. And in case the parametric equation of ellipse, that is you are to take x is equal to some expression and y is equal to some expression, so that if you use that two expressions in this equation, in the left hand side of this equation, you must get is equal to 1. and that is the parametric equation. You understood my point? Here x and y are the two expressions to be taken in such a way that if you replace that two expressions for x and y in this equation, then the left hand side will also be is equal to 1. So that will be the parametric equation of the given expression. So here, if you see here that the parametric equation of this is given by x is equal to, you see I am taking here a cos theta and y is equal to b sin theta. Do not take x is equal to a sin theta, y is equal to b cos theta, because in that case also, if you put in the left hand side of this equation, you will get the left hand side is also equal to 1 in that case also. But you do not take x is equal to in terms of sine, because x is known as the abscissa. So it must be always cos in terms of cos. Do not take x in terms of sine, because in the first year class again, you have the chapter trigonometric functions. And in trigonometric functions, if you recall that, x is always taken as the cos function and y is mean the ordinate is always taken as the sine function. So abscissa is always taken as cosine function and ordinate is always taken as the sine function. And that is why I am taking x is equal to a cos theta. If you replace here a cos theta, so finally it is a square cos square theta. This a square is cancelled, mean only cos square theta is this one. Or you, if you write like this, x by a is equal to cos theta, then x square by a square is equal to cos square theta here. And similarly, y by b is equal to sin theta, taking square, so y square by b square, mean this term is equal to sin square theta. So this is cos square theta, this is sin square theta. So finally what we will get, this is cos square theta, and from here plus this is sin square theta, and cos square theta plus sin square theta, this is obviously equal to 1, and that is the right hand side of the equation. So this is the parametric equation of the ellipse. But if you take x is equal to a sin theta, mean x is equal to, if you take x is equal to a sin theta and y is equal to b cos theta, in that case also you will get the left hand side is equal to 1. But this is not the right way. You should take x is in terms of cos and y is in terms of sine. So I am erasing this. Okay. So now it is a simple parametric equation, x equal to a cos theta, y equal to b sin theta. So dx d theta you take, dy d theta you take. But keep in mind that the last result should be in again x and y, because the given equation is given in Cartesian. So you should also write the solution of the equation, when the differentiation of the equation in terms of x and y, not in terms of theta, because you are to differentiate this just by using parametric equation. So this is the parametric equation. So to solve this equation by using parametric, and finally you are to replace those values theta by x and y only. So simply dx d theta is equal to, this is a is here, sin theta derivative is minus cos theta derivative is minus sin theta plus and the second one y. So dy d theta is equal to b cos theta only, simple. Then dy dx is equal to dy d theta divided by dx d theta. So it is b cos theta divided by a sin theta, and negative will be there. So minus b cos theta by a sin theta. So actually this is the answer. But the given equation is in Cartesian form. Therefore this expression should also be converted in Cartesian again. So b cos theta, you see cos theta is actually what? This is here, cos theta is x by a, and sin theta is actually y by b. So that two results are using here. I am using that two results for cos and sin from this line. So this b by a is already here, minus is there. So cos is x by a, this sin is y by b. Minus is there, this b will go to the numerator to make it b square, this a will come to the denominator to make it a square. So minus b square by x square, this is x, this is y, so x by y. And that is the answer. So I am taking also here, if you take the direct differentiation, if you take the direct differentiation of this equation, mean x square by a square, derivative will be, is it not twice x by a square? It is twice x by a square plus y square by b square, derivative is twice y by b square, because a square b square constant, so they will remain same. Derivative will only on x square and only on y square, but this term is remaining y, therefore you should write dy dx also, dy dx also. And on the right hand side you see that is a constant number 1, so derivative is 0. And from here you see, from here you see this 2 is cancelled, and if you simplify this you will get dy dx will also be is equal to minus of this b square will go to the numerator, that is b square by a square, and you see this y will come in the denominator, that is x by y. So this will be the result, and that is already obtained here. Okay, already obtained here. So but this problem should not be solved in the second method, mean this method you cannot apply here, this method you cannot apply, you should apply the parametric method, because in the question it is asking by using parametric equation, so you should write the derivative by using parametric equation. So I am erasing this. So our next question, you see the next question is of the similar type, actually same type question. That means a Cartesian equation will be given there, and then you are to find derivative of dy dx by using the parametric equation. So let me take that question. This is our question. If x to the power 2 by 3 plus y to the power 2 by 3 is equal to a to the power 2 by 3, this is the equation, then find dy dx by using parametric equations. Again, to take x and y, some trigonometric expressions, so that after using that two expressions for x and y here, you should get it is equal to a power 2 by 3. So here also the term x is, x should be taken in terms of cos and y should be taken in terms of sine. So you see here I am taking here the parametric equation of this is x is equal to a cos cube theta here and y is equal to a sine cube theta. So if you replace these two values of x and y in this equation, what we will get, you see here, you will get x is equal to what? X is equal to a cos cube theta. This is a cos cube theta, but x to the power what? It is 2 by 3 there. So I am writing 2 by 3 here. Then plus, this is plus, y is what? A sine cube theta. So this is sine cube theta, and that is 2 by 3 again, 2 by 3. Now you see this 2 by 3 will give us a power 2 by 3 from both terms, a power 2 by 3 is common, and here this cube and this cube root will be cancelled. So we will get it is cos square theta, you see, simply cos square theta. And from the second one, a to the power 2 by 3 is already taken away, and sine square and this cube 2 by 3, sine cube, not square, sine cube and this 3 will cancelled out. So it will be simply sine square theta. Is that clear? And sine square theta plus cos square theta will give us 1. This expression is 1 only. So we have only a to the power 2 by 3. And a to the power 2 by 3 is the right hand side of the given equation. So that is, I am taking the expression x is equal to a cos cube and y is equal to a sine cube. This is the parametric equation of the given equation, Cartesian equation. So now you take the differentiation only for this. Simple differentiation is there. So first you differentiate x, that is x is equal to a cos cube theta is that differentiation cost, a cos cube theta. So then dx d theta, this 3 will come out, so thrice a, cos square power is decreased, so cos cube decreased cos square, because 3 is coming out, cos cube is cos square, into then cos function derivative is minus sine. So finally I am taking getting here 3a, and negative will become in front, 3a cos square theta sine theta, 3a cos square theta sine theta. Okay, so the next one, y is equal to this. So dy d theta is equal to thrice a sine square is there, thrice a sine square theta, and sine function derivative is simply cos theta. So this is our dy d theta. Now dy dx will be equal to this dy d theta divided by this dx d theta. So let take the term. So dy dx is equal to dy d theta divided by dx d theta. Replace these values. Dy d theta is this one, apply here, and dx d theta is this one, apply here. So it is simply thrice a sine square theta cos theta, this one, dx dy d theta, thrice a sine square theta cos theta, and dx d theta is minus thrice a cos square theta sine theta, this one, is equal to this minus is already here, 3a is cancelled, cos cancel, this sine sine cancel, so only sine theta by cos theta is this expression. But do not write tan theta here, because this result should again be transformed in terms of x and y. So sine theta is what from the expression here? What is sine theta from here? So sine theta is y by a whole to the power 1 by 3 is cube. It is cube. So y by a whole to the power 1 by 3. Sine theta equal to y by a whole to the power 1 by 3 cube. And cos theta is equal to x by a whole to the power 1 by 3. This cube is taken in the left hand side. So dy dx is equal to this minus is here. Sine mean already I told you that it is y by a whole to the power 1 by 3, this one. And this is actually division, but I am taking into. So you take the reciprocal. It is actually x by a, but you should write a by x, because I am writing in product form here. But actually it was division. The product will be a by x whole to the power 1 by 3 only. So minus is here. A power 1 by 3 and this a power 1 by 3 is get cancelled. So y by x whole power 1 by 3 is the answer. This is the solution for the question. And if you take direct differentiation of this given Cartesian equation by using the direct formula, that is 2 by 3 into x to the power minus 1 by 3 plus you can take direct differentiation here by taking 2 by 3 x to the power minus 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3 y to the power minus 1 by 3 dy dx is equal to 0. Then from there you can obtain this result also. So the next question, is this one. So in this question you see you take this x is equal to e to the power sine inverse this, y is equal to e to the power minus cos inverse this, in that way. Actually I have done one of the question of this type. The function is given in cos x and sin x, I think, and here it is given as log x and log y. So first of all you free this x and y, e to the power this, and this is e to the power this one, and then you can find dx dt, then dy dt. So that one, so log of x is equal to this one, x is equal to e to the power this sine inverse t, then dx dt. Dx dt is equal to e to the power function derivative is itself mean e to the power sine inverse t, and then sine inverse t function derivative is 1 by root over 1 minus t square only. Okay, then you take the second one, this part. So log y is equal to this, y will be equal to e power minus cos inverse t. So therefore dy dt is equal to e to the power function derivative is same, then minus is there, but cos inverse t derivative is minus 1 by 1 minus t square, and that formula minus and this minus will make the term as positive. So now you divide this dy dt by dx dt. So dy dx is equal to dy dt divided by dx dt. Dy dt is this expression, and dy dt is dx dt is this expression. Use that two values. It is
simply this part is cancelled, you see, this part is cancelled, only e to the power minus cos inverse t divided by e to the power sin inverse t, this one. And it is, you may write this expression in terms of x and y also. You see, what is e to the power minus cos inverse t is y, so it is y, and e to the power sin inverse t is x, so this is x. So you may leave the answer here also. Also, you can write this in terms of like this one, you see, I am writing here. You can also write this as, you can also write this as e power minus cos inverse t, very sincerely, you see, e power minus cos inverse t, then minus e power minus sin inverse t. You got my point? Minus sin inverse t. Okay? This one. And that is equal to e power, if you take that minus common, so what will be the term? The term is cos inverse t plus sin inverse t. That is this one, sin inverse t. But cos inverse t plus sin inverse t will be equal to pi by 2. That is a formula. So it is e to the power minus pi by 2. So in your exam, it may be asked this way also. You see this. The question may be asked, then show that dy dx is equal to e to the power minus pi by 2. That may be one important question also. That may be also one of the important question. So then you see the next question. Number 18, find dy dx if x is equal to this, y is equal to this. Very simple. You directly take dx dt by taking a product function. E to the power theta is one of the function, and theta plus 1 by theta is the second function. dy d theta, this is first function and this is second function. Directly take. So x is equal to this. Dx d theta is equal to e to the power theta is same. Derivative e to the power theta is e to the power theta. This is the remaining as it is, plus e to the power theta is remaining as it is. Then this part derivative, theta derivative with respect to theta is 1, and 1 by theta derivative is minus 1 by theta square. This formula is already given in your differentiation in first year. And that is equal to e to the power theta is common here. From these two terms, e to the power theta is common. Theta plus 1 by theta is this one. And 1 minus 1 by theta square is this. E to the power theta remaining same. LCM will be theta square here. So theta square is LCM. It is theta cube. Then this is theta. Then this is theta square. And minus, this will be 1 only. This is your dx d theta. Take the second expression. Y is equal to e to the power minus theta into theta minus 1 by theta. Then take dy d theta. So dy d theta is equal to first e to the power minus theta derivative, that is minus e to the power minus theta. This is remaining same, plus this is remaining same. This part is derivative 1, and 1 by theta derivative is minus 1 by theta square. So minus minus is plus, is equal to e to the power minus theta is common. So this term is minus theta plus 1 by theta, this one, and this term is 1 plus 1 by theta square, this one. E to the power minus theta is remaining same, and here you are taking just simply LCM of as theta square. LCM is theta square, so it is theta square into theta is theta cube, minus is there, plus theta will be divided, theta into 1 is theta only, this is theta square only, and this is plus 1 only. Now just divide it, dy d theta divided by dx d theta, this one. So dy d theta is this expression, and dx d theta is this expression. So this divided by this, but I am taking as product here, so write the reciprocal of this one. This term is remaining same, I am giving product sign, in place of division sign. So this theta square is the numerator, and e to the power theta into this part, theta cube plus theta square, this is the denominator, this one. This theta square is cancelled, and you see here e to the power minus theta, and this e to the power minus theta taken in the numerator will be e to the power minus 2 theta, and this is remaining as it is, and this is remaining as it is. So that is the solution for the question. Okay, so the next question I am taking here, number 19. If y is equal to this one, x is equal to this one, and y is equal to this one, then find dy dx. This question can also to show that, or show that dy dx is equal to the given expression is the answer. So that question may ask in that way also. So therefore you just take x and then take dx dt, because t is variable here, t is variable. So x is equal to this. So dx dt is equal to, first of all, it is of the form, this is variable to the power a constant. So variable to the power constant is, this constant is coming in front, this one, and power is decreased by 1, this one, into, this is considering as x. So derivative of t is 1, and derivative of 1 by t is minus 1 by t square. So that is equal to, you see here, a is already here, this a is this one, but t plus 1 by t, you see from here, t plus 1 by t, it is x to the power this 1 by a. This a is coming in the power of x as 1 by a. So the result is x to the power 1 by a. So I am writing in place of this x to the power 1 by a, and this a minus 1 is already there. So a minus 1 by a will be there. This term is remaining same. Then you take the second one. Y is equal to a to the power t plus 1 by t. It is constant to the power variable. So constant to the power variable mean the formula is a to the power x formula. And a to the power x formula was a to the power x into log of a. So here a to the power this term into log of a. So dy dt is equal to, this is remaining same, and log a is the derivative of this a to the power t plus 1 by t. But t plus 1 by t is considering as x, this one. So you are to take this derivative by the chain rule. So t derivative is 1, and 1 by t derivative is 1 by minus 1 by t square is equal to, you see, this a to the power t plus 1 by t, it is obviously is equal to y. So writing here y, this log a is already here, and this term is remaining same. Now just divide this by this. So dy dx is equal to dy dt divided by dx dt. So dy dt is this term, dx dt is this term, so this will get cancelled, this is cancelled. So it is y log a divided by this term, y log a divided by a into x to the power a minus 1 by a. So y log a divided by a into x to the power a minus 1 by a, and that is the solution for the question. And today we finished the class here, and this is the end of the chapter derivative of parametric function. And in the next class I'll take the chapter derivative of function with respect to function. That will be a very short video, because derivative of function with respect to function is similar to this parametric function, exactly similar actually. So I will give 3-4 questions for the chapter, because the methods are same, just slight different asking procedure, question asking procedure is slightly different from this, but the process of solution is exactly similar to the process of differentiation of parametric function. That process is exactly same, but the asking procedure of the question is slightly different. So I should take I will take 3-4 questions only for that class, and the next class, in the subsequent class, I will take some special problems of derivative, very important question actually. Some questions are asked in your in the entrance exams also, so that questions will be given in the last of the series differentiation process. So this series will be finished in upcoming 3 classes only. So till then, thank you very much.